Hey y'all, my name is Nat. I hope you're having a terrific day today. And for this video, we are doing my December book haul. What with Christmas being here, I have many wonderful friends who bought me tons of books, but I also just bought some books for myself, no shame. I figured let's go over some of these. I have read a few of them, but rather than diving into a review, I'll point you in the direction of those with the cards up here. Let's dive right in, starting at the beginning of the month when Karen M. McManus came out with a new book, The Cousins. Naturally, I had to go pick this up the day it came out. She always does great mysteries and some big twist that happens at the end that will constantly catch me off guard no matter what. I've attempted to summarize this book many a times now, but I honestly always feel like I'm not doing it justice, so I'm just gonna read the inside sleeve. Millie, Aubrey, and Jonah are cousins, but they barely know each other, and they've never even met their grandmother. Rich and reclusive, she disinherited their parents before they were born, so when they each receive a letter inviting them to work at her island resort for the summer, they're surprised and curious. Their parents are unwavering on one point. Not going is not an option. This could be their chance to get back in grandmother's good graces, but when the cousins arrive on the island, it's immediately clear that she has different plans for them. And the longer they stay, the more they realize how mysterious and dark their family's past is. I'm planning to buddy read this with Kim over at Kimberly Reads at some point, but I keep being overly ambitious with my TBRs, so I have no idea when I'm finally gonna get to it, but I'm excited for when I do. On that same trip to Barnes & Noble, I also picked up These Violent Delights by Chloe Gong. This was supposed to be a book club read for my personal book club, but we ended up changing it about halfway through the month. This is a debut novel coming from a 22-year-old, I think. Can we just appreciate the fact that she is already published a book at her age? How crazy is that? This is a Romeo and Juliet retelling set in 1920s Shanghai amid gangs, and honestly, sold already, very invested at the point I already am. Next, due to a lack of self-control, I signed up for Book of the Month, and my first choice was In Holidays by Christina Lauren. This was also a book club read for two separate book clubs, as well as my group read for the Disney Channel Games Readathon. I'll put a link to that vlog right here. This is a holiday rom-com following May, who always spends Christmas with her friends and family at this cabin. However, the owners have decided to sell, but something ends up happening and May ends up reliving the entire vacation. Anytime she gets hit on the head, it automatically starts back over. However, this might be her chance to fix an awkward encounter that occurred the first time around, as well as possibly finally end up with the guy she's been crushing on since she was like 13. The next book is also a holiday romance, and that is The 12 Dates of Christmas by Jenny Bayliss. I picked this up because of the 12 Days of Bookmas readathon. This story is following a woman named Kate who signs up for a dating website, and she is being set up with 12 different men in the weeks leading up to Christmas. Next, my boyfriend's mom actually lent me a book, Alice by Christina Henry. We had been talking about this and I found out she owned it, so she was kind enough to lend it to me for the time being. I'm gonna read off the summary for you guys. In a warren of crumbling buildings and desperate people called the Old City stands a hospital with cinder block walls that echo the screams of the poor souls inside. In the hospital, there is a woman. Her hair, once blonde, hangs and tangles down her back. She doesn't remember why she's in such a terrible place. Just a tea party long ago and long ears and blood. Then, one night, a fire at the hospital gives the woman a chance to escape. She tumbles out of the hole that imprisoned her, leaving her free to uncover the truth about what happened to her all those years ago. Only something else has escaped with her, something dark, something powerful. And to find the truth, she will have to track this beast to the very heart of the Old City, where the rabbit waits for his Alice. She told me this is very weird, and given that I've read multiple weird books this year that I really enjoyed, can't wait! Finally, I'm gonna jump into the books I was given as gifts for Christmas. First off is Pretty Girls by Karen Slaughter. My boyfriend was kind enough to give this to me. Given that I don't actually know a lot of what this is about, I'm gonna read the summary off the back. It's been more than 20 years since Claire and Lydia last spoke. Claire is the glamorous trophy wife of an Atlanta millionaire. Lydia, a single mother dating an ex-con, struggles to make ends meet. But neither has recovered from the disappearance of their sister Julia 2 decades earlier, and the shocking murder of Claire's husband brings the horror and heartbreak of the past roaring back into their lives. The vanishing of a teenage girl and the killing of a middle-aged man, almost a quarter century apart. What could connect them? As they form a wary truce, the surviving sisters unearth the secrets that destroyed their family all those years ago and find the astonishing truth where they least expected it. I have heard nothing but good things about this from Haley, from Caroline, from Jess, and I cannot wait to finally pick it up. I've heard it's going to give me tons of nightmares and I am ready for it. Next, as a part of the Page Turner Book Club's gift exchange, I received A Smoke Gets in Your Eyes and Other Tales from the Crematory by Caitlin Doughty. This is a memoir following Caitlin Doughty, who is a mortician and crematory operator. Fascinating, it's funny, it's deep, it's dark. Honestly, this is probably one of my favorite nonfiction reads I've read in quite a while, and I'm gonna put a link to the wrap-up video where I review it right here. Thank you to Haley from the Page Turner Book Club for gifting this to me. Next, I received Horrid by Katrina Lino from the wonderful Morgan at Morgan's Chaotic World. I'll put a link to her channel in the description down below. Definitely go check her out. This is a book that honestly, I saw the cover and I was immediately adding it to my want to read list. Morgan made me promise to buddy read this with her, which I definitely will be doing. But for the time being, let me read you guys the summary. Following her father's death, Jane North Robinson and her mom, Rethelyn, moved from sunny California to the dreary, dilapidated old house in Maine where Ruth grew up. All they want is a fresh start, but behind North Manor's doors lurks a history that leaves them feeling more alone and more tortured. As the cold New England autumn arrives and Jane settles into her new home, she finds solace in old books and memories of her dad. She steadily begins making friends, but Jane also faces bullying from the resident bad seed and struggles to tamp down her own worst nature in response. Ruth seems to be spiraling with the return of her childhood home, but she won't reveal why. Then Jane discovers that the storage room Ruth has kept locked isn't for storage at all. It's a little girl's bedroom, left untouched for years and not quite as empty of inhabitants as it appears. Cannot wait to get into this. This sounds creepy and weird, and I'm ready for it. Next up, my wonderful friend Allie bought me a Date with a Book package, and she put that I love thrillers, so I received The Silent Bride by Leslie Glass. I have never heard of this, and I understand that was the entire point of the system, but I'm very intrigued already. The Sheltered Bride. A beautiful bride's glorious trip down the aisle is cut short by a sniper's bullet. The crime has stunned the city and baffled NYPD detective April Wu. The sweet, modest 18-year-old virgin couldn't have had an enemy in the world. The Selfish Bride. Under the magnificent steeples of St. Patrick's Cathedral, a posh society wedding ends in the same horror. Rich and spoiled, the second bride shares only one thing with the victim before her, getting caught in the crosshairs of a madman's gun. The Silent Bride. What links the startling crimes? Who's next to die? With the wedding of April's friend fast approaching, April and homicide specialist Mike Sanchez sift through the evidence for clues to the killer's identity. But they have to work fast, because the mysterious motive and the next target are becoming dangerously clear. Finally, the wonderful page at the PM Reader, whose account I will link in the description down below, sent me The Six of Crows duology by Leigh Bardugo. I have never read these. I am planning to read them as part of the Grishaverse read-along, which is being hosted by a bunch of awesome YouTubers. I'll put all the info down below. The only Leigh Bardugo book I have read thus far is Ninth House, but I've heard nothing but good things about her Grishaverse series, and honestly, so many people have recommended me Six of Crows that I feel like I just have to read it at this point to satisfy them. All I know about this duology is it is following an unlikely group of people who have to go on a heist, and I love heist stories, so I am sold. I also think it's in a fantastical world, pretty sure. All right, y'all, so that is all the books I received in December. Tell me in the comments down below, did you get some awesome books for Christmas? Let me know. As always, thank you so much for coming to my channel. I really appreciate it. Make sure to hit like and subscribe down below. I come out with videos on Monday and Friday, but until then, I hope you continue to have a terrific day. Bye.